In this episode, we're making four Unreal Engine usage comparisons between two workstations. An old 4-core Intel i7 machine versus a new 12-core AMD Ryzen. Although our Intel machine is 11 years old, it's still going strong for graphics and video editing. Recently, two of our patrons traveled across the Atlantic for a visit, surprising us with a brand new, fully sponsored AMD Ryzen workstation for our studio. We did four tests to measure the performance difference while doing identical Unreal Engine tasks. The first test is to launch Unreal Engine 4.27 via the Epic Games launcher and then start a new blank project. On both machines, this was done directly after a reboot. In these tests, we'll be looking at how much time is wasted waiting for the old machine. As you can see, by the time we start creating the new project on the new machine, the old one is still loading the Epic Games launcher. In the end, the old machine wasted 2 minutes and 51 seconds. The new machine is very quick, at 4.3 times faster. However, 16 seconds accounted for user interaction in setting up the new project. If we discounted that, then the new machine is about 6 times faster. The second test is to load the truck and trailers project, which we got from the Unreal Engine Marketplace. We sped up the screen capture video clips to spare you the agony of waiting through all of this. The task manager shows the system specs and the CPU thread activity. After initializing and loading, the old machine opens the UE4 editor after 6 minutes and 50 seconds. Something which takes the new machine only 2 minutes and 20 seconds. After that, each machine compiles shaders, something Unreal Engine users are familiar with. 8 threads are in use on the Intel CPU, while 24 threads run on the AMD. The moment the shaders are compiled, we stop the clocks. What one machine did in 15 minutes and 49 seconds took the other only 3 minutes and 55 seconds, making it 4 times faster. We wasted 11 minutes and 54 seconds on the old machine. Oh no. The third test is to launch the City Park Environment Collection project, which has already been downloaded and created, but with 0 shaders compiled. Each machine must simply reboot, launch UE4.26, load the project, and compile the shaders. It's good to quantify how productive you are with the equipment you have to see where you can save time. Time saved does not just mean work is completed sooner, but it also results in more iterations to achieve a far better version of your creative vision. Take note that both workstation GPUs have only 8 GB of VRAM. The one huge gain on the new workstation is having more and faster CPU cores, while the other gain is having lots more RAM. 64 GB of RAM on the new system offers far greater stability, resulting in far less Unreal Engine crashes, which saves even more time and frustration. The results are in. The old machine crashed after 1 hour and 25 minutes, while the new one took 29 minutes and 56 seconds to successfully load the scene. After multiple crashes on the old machine, we gave up, with many hours wasted. The final test is to have each workstation import the same MetaHuman into a blank UE4.27 project via the Quixel bridge, and then compile the shaders. This is a custom MetaHuman we made in MetaHuman Creator, already downloaded on each machine, so we're not spoiling the test with different download speeds. With UE4.27 already open, the test started as soon as we clicked the export button in Bridge. Once again, this process is significantly accelerated for your viewing pleasure. The timecode on the old machine tells a terrible tale of woe. It's proof that over the period of a year, all the hours lost may have accrued to weeks and perhaps even months. On the old machine, we wait to load the application, wait to load the project, wait to compile shaders, and wait for renders. If there's a crash, which happens frequently, you wait for all of that all over again. On a slow machine, the actual time spent on creative work inside a scene is just the bare minimum to have something which works. There's hardly any time for refinements. This tests your patience, your sanity, your relationships, your resolve, and even career choices. Getting the bigger and faster machine early on is clearly the smart choice. When it comes to Unreal Engine, we reckon the focus should be lots of RAM first, 32 gigabytes minimum, then lots of fast CPU cores, and a high-end GPU with more than 8 gigabytes VRAM if you can, and of course, SSDs or NVMe drives. All this is expensive, but well worth it if you consider we're doing virtual filmmaking on a computer. Okay, the results are in. The old machine took a super long 57 minutes and 57 seconds, while the new one took only 8 minutes and 26 seconds. Waiting 8 minutes to load a fresh MetaHuman is already a long wait. Working on the old machine wasted 49 minutes and 31 seconds, making the new machine 6.8 times faster. As expected, gear does matter. Do you struggle with Unreal Engine on your hardware setup? Please post your comments below.